The geophyte pictured here is a species of Hippeastrum or amaryllis. Amaryllis is typically 1 to 2 feet tall, as shown here. And here you can see what the leaves look like. So they're a bright green color, they're very flat, strap-like leaves, and they're several inches across. They're also quite glossy. So if you look at the flowers of amaryllis, you might confuse them with the flowers of a lily, but the leaves are quite different. Here we have basal strap-like leaves and a separate flowering stem. On a lily, you have much smaller linear leaves, and those leaves are coming off of the same stem as the flower. Usually, you'll actually get the scape with the flower on amaryllis coming up first, and then the leaves come out later. And here you can see the leaves once again when they're fully expanded. The flower bud for amaryllis is quite large. It's usually a couple of inches long and sort of ellipsoidal shaped. It is a dichasium. You have 3 flowers per inflorescence and they are terminal. And here's what the flowers look like. So they have actinomorphic symmetry, usually around 6 tepals, and this is a gigantic flower, 4 to 6 inches across, usually larger than the flowers of a lily. Amaryllis flowers tend to be white, pink, red, or orange in color. So here's a pink one. You can see the floral parts, and the way that the pistil extends past the stamens is pretty typical. Also, it's a little hard to see in this picture, but you'll notice that the stigma is forked into 3 lobes. Now, I said that Hippeastrum usually has actinomorphic symmetry. Here's an example of a Hippeastrum flower that has more zygomorphic symmetry and has a pretty distinctive coloration and pattern to it. So there are, again, a lot of cultivars, a lot of species of this plant out there, and so there is quite a bit of variety amongst them. Now, amaryllis is a tunica bulb, and the bulb is quite large, significantly larger than any of the other bulbs that we've seen. It's usually several inches in diameter, and a lot of times you'll see this bulb because it's commonly sold, particularly around Christmas time, in little houseplant kits at all kinds of different stores, and you'll just get this giant bulb in a pot. So with that, we conclude our discussion of Hippeastrum, the amaryllis.